Sorry, let's get something a little more less R&B.
I guess three. I had to think so slow, bro. Let me see. Oh, my God. Why are you so slow? I don't know if I'm doing this right.
I'm trying to screen share.
Aren't you sharing right now or not? Here you go.
And like, there's like a waiting room, and I don't know how to like let people in. Yeah, back on. Ah, it's under her fucking
Yeah.
Oh.
There you go.
Okay, nice. Now I see it. Okay. All right, so now can I, all right, can I now, people in, there's like, I don't know if there's a waiting room. What's up, Cherie?
Hi, good morning. Hi.
How you doing?
Okay.
Deep breaths?
Yeah. Do I have 2 minutes?
You're good.
All right, just give me 2 minutes.
Oh, quick, 90s throwback, 80s comeback, or 80s comeback, 90s throwback, and it's playing fun. Like, I don't get it. It's like, like 2000.
Sorry.
Well, it's my fault. It's got a thumbs up on it. All right, so we're having conversations today, huh? So what now? Huh?
So there's, it's me, Sarah.
Sure. I won't keep it rolling for long. You know, it's like it's recorded now.
Yeah.
No, that means gotta watch the lingo. Work. Work right now. Script. Dialogue is like professional. Yeah, but I don't know. Zero. Just can I see the waiting room?
Click on the dot. Bottom. That's it. Click on enable waiting room. Or is it grayed out? I think Courtney has to let him in.
I'm Courtney.
You are?
But it's not Courtney, it's Jordana. Oh. So this is under Jordana. My thing is under Jordana. All right, it's 10:02. Not much to do, you know. All right. Try to put some vibes on for the morning. I know it's like a rainy day. Nobody's like wanting to do anything today. Is that the vibe? Nobody wants to do anything today. So literally, it's just me, you, Tara, and I was saying you because it's yeah. Sydney. Me, Sydney, Tara, and I think Sherry's here. All right. So we have a what do we have today? We have a
power hour
at 4:45. Okay. Tara, will you be attending?
Yes, I'll see you guys there.
Okay, awesome. Sydney, you're here?
Yeah.
Rock and rolling. Okay. So there's not too many people on here, and I'm probably going to blame myself for that because I don't really promote this like I probably should. But it is very important to kind of like have some type of insight on like improving your skills, right? So this is recorded, so I'm just going to talk like there's a bunch of people here.
I probably shouldn't have said that because, you know, it would probably been a better recording. Right. But no. So there's just a few things I'll probably touch on. And then we'll just have a light conversation. I won't keep you on too long. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to invite more people. I mean, can you look at them, make sure I don't know if I'm inviting people who are invited, but
is there people in the waiting room? I can't tell.
I have no idea how that works.
I'm sorry. So if there is people on Zoom, or trying to get on and you couldn't, sorry. Because I'm like dumb when it comes to this stuff. So let's just have a regular conversation. Just talk about a few things in regards to strategically talking to people.
Press the X on that.
The X?
Yeah.
This one?
Yeah.
And how do I know if like people are wanting to come in? I don't know.
Participants?
Yeah, but there's only three.
Okay.
And I don't know what this invite means. I don't know what that means. So I don't know if like people are waiting and I just can't see that they're waiting more. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We're just not here.
Mm-hmm. All right, so whatever. I'm just gonna rock and roll. And I won't take too much time. I'll just do 30 minutes since there's not too many people here. But I just want to have like maybe just like a little inside kind of type of conversation, whatever. All right.
So you can see the screen. Can you see me, Tara?
Yes, I can see you.
You see me, but you don't see the screen, do you?
No, I can't read it.
You can't see it because I'm talking.
I see it. I see it on the screen. On the
behind
left.
Me?
Yeah. No, I see it on the screen. Is it says I like to refer to what I teach as conversational choreography.
Yeah. Oh, so you do see it. Okay. All right. So that's where I wanted to go. Never mind.
Okay.
All right, cool. All right. So let me just
there right. We go. Okay.
Cool. So when making calls and talking to people, right? I always say we have to break down barriers, right? Because the thing is we're nobody to them, but we can change their life. You know, it's kind of like one of those dating app things, you know? It's like you scroll left, but if you just scrolled right, you could have made the best decision of your life type. That's how I feel about it. I'm not on dating sites, so I don't know how that works. But but that's what people tell me. So a big thing here is tackling the script. So I feel like if you don't have a structured script that you guys kind of go off of, you kind of lose your sense of direction, right? So when you have a script, it's really like a map. Right. So it's going to give you the obstacles that most people are going to say. And then you kind of have to make it your own when you're rebutting them. Right. So in this first part, it says in Hollywood, there's a saying among actors that says the script is the enemy. That does not mean that actors do not like or do not use scripts. Scripts are a part of the business. The enemy is when it sounds like you're performing from a script. And I think that's very important because a lot of things that we say a lot. Can I say that right? A lot of the things or phrases that we say, especially when we're on the phone, when we're having these contacts, are all the same conversation,
yeah.
Right? So that means we just have to approach it. We have to have the same outcome. We just need to understand what our goal is at the end of it, right? So right here, it talks about having a choreographed conversation. And that's really what a script is, right? So it's to get you from point A to point B to getting either the appointment or being able to have a secure follow-up on your client or your customer, right? So when you're having conversations, do you guys use a script is what I'm asking. Sydney?
Not like a written one.
Not like a written one.
I think I need to structure it more.
Mm-hmm.
Just because halfway through, I feel like it kind of petals out and then they don't want to talk anymore.
So when you look, okay, so when you sit down and you make your calls,
mm-hmm.
and you have your mental script,
yeah,
what is 1 through 4
like
in your head?
Intro, introducing who I am, asking like if there's still.
Any can you hear it, Tara?
Yes, I'm listening.
You can hear her. I just want to make sure you can hear her. Yeah. Okay,
thank you.
So like my intro, introducing who I am, and then figuring out what their needs are. And it's pretty much like, we got like a sheet that's like why, what, who, when. And I kind of just go through that. But sometimes roadblocks come up and they're not interested or they don't want to talk to you for that long. And that's when like problems arise.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Okay. So. Do you feel that you have a choreographed way to get around those obstacles?
Not at the moment.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, but you do feel strong enough. You do feel strong enough that if you had those steps, you would
be able
to.
I could work my way through a conversation, mm-hmm. but it's like not like a dance. It's more like you're just stomping through.
You're just kind of stomping.
Yeah.
And that's kind of like the thing. And that's why. A lot of this is about practice, right? So today we have our power hour, right? Jonathan's hosting it. So it should be fun. It's a pretty fun guy. My thing is I want you guys to find your own script or go with the scripts that we have. So I have a thing called Red X. Red X has, for what I'm calling, it already has like a like a script for me, but it doesn't go into detail in regards to like tonality and like all that stuff. All this stuff you'll find in like this book. And I always refer to this book for you guys. It's The Book of Yes by Kevin Ward. He's amazing. The guy knows exactly what he's talking about. And it's more of like that Tony Robbins. You know how Tony Robbins like motivates you, right? But Kevin Ward understands you and how to get you motivated, right? So the main thing with us is the people that we deal with have their vision of how the transaction is supposed to go. And then we have the reality of how the transaction is going to go, right? So our knowledge gives us an opportunity to advance our conversation to the point where they feel more trustworthy of you. Is what I want to say. And then it comes from experience, but I do want like a choreographed conversation is a better way. And it, just like it says in here, you know, you kind of have to practice it so much and say it so many times to a point where it's second nature to you. Like for me, I can talk about Palm Beach, really. I can talk about most of South Florida till I get to about Hollywood, Pembroke Pines, I can even go to Plantation, but I'll stomp through Plantation. You know, I can ice skate through here, you know, because I know where I'm going. I know where the values are at. It's more of an education thing, but it's also a confidence thing, right? So when we're on the phone, we're talking to our clients, customers, we have to exude confidence over the phone that we know what we're doing and who we are, right? And when I say who we are, it's your value, right? So have you ever celebrated something like your birthday or something and you bought yourself something, right?
It's to treat yourself.
You treat yourself, okay? So Sherry, what was the last big thing that you bought yourself?
Oh, well, let's see. My car.
Okay. Her car. And you have what? A 3 Series BMW?
Yeah.
It's beautiful. I love it. Tan interior. Mm-hmm. She's gorgeous. I really wanted one of those things, man.
Yeah, I love my car.
Oh, I love your car. Okay. So the reason why you got a BMW 3 Series is because that's your value. Do you see? So if I'm a person on the other end and I have a multi-million dollar property, I want somebody that I know knows the value of my property, or you know, and can show that value up front, right? That's why it's hard for like a brand new agent to get like a $3 million property or like a $10 million listing or whatever the case may be, or buyer or whatever it is. One, most of these people have connections. Fortunately for us, a lot of the people who are moving here don't. If it was, if I was in New York, I would never have gotten a big deal. No way. No way. But it's because I'm not an expert. Like, if I have a great realtor in New York, and if I wanted to go somewhere in Manhattan, I look at his split. He's the person that's going to get a deal. Right? They're going to refer me to somebody that knows what they're talking about. Mm-hmm. Here, unfortunately, well, fortunately for us, unfortunately for them, right? They're coming into an area that's constantly being developed. Yeah. Right? 2 years ago, or a year ago, I'll say 2 years ago, the Ray wasn't there. And now it looks like it belongs. Do you know? So that confidence for you on the other end, or for that person on the other end, maybe, I don't know what I want right now, but if I had to work with somebody, I'd work with Sherry. You know, or I work with Tara, or I work with Sydney, you know? And I think internalizing a script helps you get to that next level of like conversations, right? Because you don't wanna just, the reason why we're on the phone is because, I don't say practice makes perfect, but you know, that's really where the money is. Mm-hmm. If you need to go ahead and reach out and grab one, you know, that's where it's at. If not, you know, it's all about regular day-to-day conversations, right? And those people are still going to trust you to know. Yeah, it's raining. It's crazy. Those people are still going to trust you to know what you're talking about in your field, mm-hmm. you know? So I kind of wanted you to, there's a few scripts. I don't know if you have one. Do you have one, Sherry? Or are you just?
No, you know, there was script that I, when I first, you know, that I used to look at. Mm-hmm. But basically, I have it like memorized in my mind exactly what I'm saying, so I don't need to
go off.
Yeah. But I did. I used to look at it.
You used to actually write one?
Yeah, and so I knew exactly what I was doing, you know, like all the questions that I wanted to ask, and yeah. Okay. But at this point, unless, you know, you have people that don't want to talk to you, that's a difficult situation. Mm-hmm. But when you have like a normal conversation, you know, it's basically always the same introduction, just making yourself, you know, the other person to feel comfortable mm-hmm. on the phone that they want to talk to you. So you always try and have something in common with that person.
So do you look for some type of rapport?
Right. So yeah, exactly. You know. First, you just say, "Now, hi, how are you?" And you know, and then when they say, "Oh, great, how are you?" And like, thank you so much for asking. You know, because you want to give the feedback. Just keep on doing it. Mm-hmm. And then if they, let's say they were looking for something in Boca or whatever. Oh, I love Boca. I've been in this area for 25 years. It's great. That, you know. So then you go from there. That's mm-hmm. just always. That's just what I find works. Just trying to build on everything that they say.
So do you feel, because sometimes when I, you know, while I'm having a conversation, I feel like I've already, there's like a point where you open the door.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely.
Like, it's no longer hard to like start talking to them. Now you're actually talking to them.
Right. That's right? What I'm saying. We have to get to that point. So in order to do that, you got to just make them feel very comfortable, like as if you were talking to your friend on mm-hmm. the phone.
Exactly. And I love that part because it's those walls, because everybody's so tense, right? Mm-hmm. Everybody's like so tense. Everybody has shit they have to do, like whatever.
They don't want to talk to a salesperson. They want to talk to a nice person on the phone. You know, they don't want somebody just selling them something.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Tara, I'm going to get to you, but I just want to have an example. So I had this gentleman yesterday who had a really good idea. I met him at a, like one of those meet and greet, like happy hours, right?
Oh.
Younger guy, you know, right? Like early 30s or whatever, like 31 or something. And odd things. So yesterday I come here and I knew I was supposed to meet the guy like around 1:00, right? I gave him the address. Guy never called me. I'm like, okay, whatever. And I was still hungry. So I was like, I'm still going to go to lunch, you know? So as I'm walking down the street, he recognizes me. Like, he sees me. I don't recognize him. He sees me, though, right? Sees me. I'm like, okay, cool. I'm like, whoa, that was weird. You know, like, I was just going to lunch, and you end up, like, stalking me or something, right? So it was awkward. And I'm like, okay. And he had like his company logo on his shirt or whatever. I'm like, okay. So I'm like, are we still going to go to lunch? Now, mind you, our plan was to go lunch or coffee or something like that to have a conversation.
Was it like a listening appointment or just a
buy? It wasn't a listening appointment. He was trying to sell me. Oh. You know, it was like kind of like one of those, I met him there. He's trying to expand his business. We had a good conversation while he was there. So he wanted to have another one.
Yeah.
So I'm like, all right, cool. I'll entertain it. Not a problem. Right. So we end up going to Isabeta's, right? Whatever. I wanted some lunch. I was starving. So he goes and he starts talking to me about mortgage insurance. It's like short-term, whatever. And I'm like, all right. He said, sounded good, but he was so salesy. You know, like a concept was good, but him himself just threw me off.
He turned you off, yeah.
You know, like I'm there, you know, it's lunch, you know. Yeah. You know how I do at lunch. I gotta have something, right? So I'm like, let me get a Peroni.
Yeah.
He's like, I'll just take a water. I'm like, okay, cool. That's fine. You know, let me get a water too. And I'm like, let me get a water too. And then I'm like, do you want something to eat? No. And this is just like not human nature, but just like unspoken, right? So if I say, do you want me to get you something? I'm paying for it.
Yeah.
Right? I can tell he's a younger guy. He's trying to make things happen, whatever. And I'm just here for a conversation, you know? And he's like, oh, no, I'm good. I got some things I got to do and this and that, so forth. Jordana's a really long game. We're just having a conversation. There's not too many people here, Jay. So the gentleman come and he's not like reciprocating, you know, like if I'm opening up to you, you kind of have to pick up on those cues of opening up and stop trying to sell me, you know.
Yeah, right.
In our business, it's we make connections, mm-hmm. right? People want to do business with you because two things actually. First thing is they trust you, right? Secondly, they like you,
right?
Mm-hmm. They trust you and they like you and they know you know what you're doing. Yeah. If not, at least you're resourceful enough.
Is it all that's on?
I don't know. I can't tell.
What's tarot?
I can't even. I don't know. It had like a waiting room.
I think it's for you.
Right? So is that her that logged in? All right. So, this is being recorded. All right. So, but had he been more a person to me, you know, and not trying to sell me, I might have done something, mm-hmm. or at least got him some other connections.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
But because he was so hungry, but I offered him food. Do you see the contrast there?
Well, you feel uncomfortable if you went out with your friends and you just sat
there. And they just sat there. Like I have friends with me, and like I go through this like kind of thing where I don't drink like alcohol, but I'm like still social.
Yeah.
And they're like, you're not drinking. And I'm like, is that a problem? Like, yeah, I'm still here. I'm still social.
Yeah.
It's just that it you're not relatable anymore. Right. And we have to make sure that we're always putting on our caps to be relatable to people.
Yeah.
Now, Tara, I was going to, you know, get to you because, you know,
hi there.
We got a small group here, so I'm trying to spread the love here. Can you kind of give me, do you have a script that you work off of? And, or do you, how do you make your calls?
I have a script that I use to just kind of keep me on track, but I don't read off a script. I mean, it's just, I always have it there, so I don't get off track. And I, you know, it's basically like your opening, why, when, where, what.
Mm-hmm.
And it keeps me focused and not lose track. So I get to those points, but I don't go off the script, you know.
All right. So let's do a role play, me and you.
Okay.
So you go ahead and be the, and the way we're going to go through this conversation is we're going to have we're going to have a conversation, and I'm going to be the buyer. You're going to be the agent. And then afterwards, we're going to double back and see how we can be more efficient on like what we're doing. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So go ahead. Call me.
Ring, ring.
Hello.
Hi, Roney. This is Tara from the home search site. I see you're looking in Delray to purchase. Are you looking to purchase in the next few months or are you just browsing?
All right. So we're going to stop again right there in the beginning. Right. So we introduce her. Okay. Hello. My name is Roney. And is this Roney? You got to say it kind of like we're like you called an old friend, but you didn't save it correctly.
I understand what you mean.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
So like, hello, Roney, you know, like you're going to say it, you're going to say my name and I'm going to say yes. And I'll say normally, who's this? Right. Cause I don't recognize your number. Right. I'm going to say, who's this? And then you're going to say, oh, this is Tara. You're, you know, the realtor from whatever the website. And I noticed that you were in looking at Delray. You know, I was just giving you a call to see how I would be able to help.
Okay.
Something along those lines, right? But I wanted you to do it as if you're speaking to a friend. Do you know, like if somebody's short, huh? Yeah, make it intentional. Make it intentional.
So can you say, hi, how are you today?
Like, yeah. You know, like inquisitive, but just like still confident. So go ahead again.
Okay, ring, ring.
Hello?
Hi, is this Roney?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
Hi, Roney. This is Tara from the home search site. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic, Tara. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you. I'm actually an agent in Delray, and I see that you've been looking to purchase a home. Are you looking to purchase in the next 3 to 6 months, or are you just browsing?
That was really good.
That was wonderful, Tara.
That was really good.
Hi.
Tara, that was awesome.
Thank you.
You brought me through every emotion in that small window of conversation, right? You showed concern. You showed that you obviously you know that I was looking at property. Like you were confident I was looking at property, but you were concerned that I was looking at property. Do you see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And how that tonality came through. It makes me want to talk to you longer because it sounds like I'm dealing with somebody that's a professional. Okay. All right. So let's go a little bit further. Tara, I was actually on the website. Me and my family are looking to expand. I got a newborn and I think Delray Beach would be a great place to raise children.
That's great. That's exactly what our site is for. I'm just curious. Let me start over, Roney.
No, you're good. Just go ahead through. Go ahead through.
Start over with me.
Okay. Me and my family are looking to expand. I have a brand newborn that just got here, and I think Delray would be a great place to raise my family.
Well, Delray is a beautiful city, and there's a lot of great schools there. So what are you looking to do? Are you looking to make a move in the next 3 to 6 months, or are you just browsing to see what your options are?
A little bit of both, but if I did have a time frame, I'd probably be more on the 3 month window right there.
Well, that's fantastic. This is the perfect time to start looking. You said you're having a newborn, and let me ask you, how many bedrooms would be ideal for you?
That's what I'm talking about, right? That's what I'm talking about right there. Because that question, because I really told you when I had that newborn, so you don't know how many kids I have. Mm-hmm. I just told you I had a newborn and my family's expanding. Mm-hmm. I might already have 3 kids and I got a newborn. I might need 4 bedrooms, or I might be newly married and then we just had a baby and I only need 2 bedrooms. Mm-hmm. Do you see? That was perfect. That was awesome. No, I'm looking for anywhere from a 3 to 4 bedroom. It's me, my wife, our son, who's about 7, and then the newborn on the way.
Very nice. That's exciting.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's a lot going on right now for me, but I think this market's getting a little expensive for me, so I don't know if I can even afford to buy anything at this point in time.
Well, now is a great time to be looking. We know that interest rates are going to be on the rise.
Yeah, you're good. Go. You're good. You're good.
I'd like to get a little more information of what you are looking for as the neighborhoods you would like. Would you like a gated community? Would you like a pool? What exactly is it that would check all your boxes in a new home?
Okay, so ideally I need anywhere from three to four bedrooms. I'm okay with anything over minimum 1800 square feet. The pool is not a big deal because I have young kids, so I don't want the water to be back there. I would like it to be, gated community would be nice, but it's not a make or break. And I have some dogs. I have a few pets, so I probably need a yard.
Oh, fantastic. How many pets do you have?
I have one Rottweiler, weighs about 80 pounds, and a Shih Tzu.
Oh, so you have about three kids, actually. Well, yeah, two are on the way.
Yeah, basically.
Okay, well, what I'd like to do is set up a search for you. What is the price range that you'd be comfortable with?
Okay, see, I wanted you, because I wanted you to kind of go back to that, but I didn't want to throw you off your leg. Okay. So when I told you I'm not sure what I could afford, you should have went the route of finding out.
Okay. Right?
So now, don't get me wrong, I like the way you went already, because you had me dreaming of the house. Do you see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So when you said what was the bucket list, so it's different. You know, what was the bucket list? What's your ideal? This and that. What's your must-haves? Those are always, it's the same thing, right? I'm asking the same question. I'm just rephrasing it, right? Depending on my conversation. So you had me actually thinking of the house, which is fantastic, right? Mm-hmm. But once I said, I'm not sure if I can even afford it, you should have been like, okay, you should have been paused. That should have paused you. And be like, okay, have you spoken with someone in regards to a mortgage, or were you planning on doing this cash?
Okay.
Right? Because then if I told you, oh, I'm doing it cash, then I would have gave you a number.
Okay.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So but you still did it right. But when I was saying the choreographed conversation, it's you need to, you know, sometimes take that sidestep.
Yes. An important question to know.
Yes, it's an important it's an important question to know. And sometimes people are very timid about speaking about money.
Right.
But you have to understand you are a professional and money is what gets things done here. Yeah. Do you know? Mm-hmm. So if I tell you, if you ever hear, you know, that it's kind of a trigger, right? It's a trigger word. If I'm not sure if I can afford it. Okay. So let me ask you this. Boom. And then you you ask that question so you can figure out what your next part of the conversation is going to be. Right. Because now I have a vision of my house in my head. And then now I got to tell you what I think I can afford. Right.
Mm-hmm.
But if we went through the money first, then we could have had the dream after. Right.
Yeah.
I give you all this, these numbers, or I give you all these dreams. Right. I gave you a house, 3-2 yard, don't need a pool, doesn't matter if it's gay, and I can only spend $250. What you got? Right?
Right, and you would have been crushed. When they open the door there, you have to roll with it then.
Yeah. But this is the thing, you would have been crushed. I would have been crushed. Yeah. Right? Right? But if we had that conversation about money first, I could have maybe told you, well, it doesn't sound like a single family home to me. It sounds more like a villa. Mm-hmm. Or a townhouse,
right?
But then you know your market. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like I keep saying, you see what I'm saying? I need to stop that. But you get my drift?
Yes.
You know, I'm trying to rephrase it. You get my drift? right? So it's you can still go down that route, but then you just have to, you know, reorganize it for them, because maybe in their mind they think they can get a single family home, but then they tell you they can only afford 280, then you're like, okay, that's really like a townhouse,
yeah,
or a villa, right? Where we can't get the house now. Get some, let's make sure we can get something for you guys for the time being, right? Mm-hmm. Your kid's 7, the other one's newborn. Newborn is going to spend most of the time with you anyway. They don't need a room right now. Do you see? So yeah. You kind of like, because you're in different phases in people's lives, right? So different things work different at the different times. So maybe I do have a newborn. I'm willing to at least make a purchase because I'm moving down from somewhere, right? Make a purchase. And then in 2 years, when my daughter or my son is 2.5, 3, and my 7-year-old is now 9 or 10, I can come back and revisit it. But at least I have a place I've lived. You made your sale, and then I trust you because you knew exactly what I needed at that time.
Mm-hmm.
And when I come back, guess who I'm going to deal with? The person who did me right in the beginning, right? But it all starts from this initial conversation. I've been talking for a while. Sydney, you guys want to
I just feel like people don't know how to articulate what they want either.
But this is the thing. And
I was on the phone with Bench and white cabinets about 10 times. The only thing that was important to him was that I had white cabinets in the kitchen, because when I got down to it, white cabinets to him meant updated house, meant open counters with granite. But the white, just white cabinets to him was super important.
He can always paint it.
Which I said, so is it the openness of the kitchen?
Or is it just the cabinets?
He said, well, I want it new and I want an island with granite.
That's different.
Okay. And I was like, so we did white cabinets with open kitchen.
But that's a perfect example, right?
And I was just like,
that's the perfect example because you're the professional.
Yeah.
When they're saying things, they're watching HGTV.
Exactly.
They're watching $1 million listing, yes. You know, like they're like, yeah, I needed to be more feng shui. And it's like, do you even know what feng shui is, bro? Do you see what I'm saying? Like, there's not enough plants in here for it to be feng shui. Chill out. You know, it's all great. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Right.
But it's crazy. We had to get there. And I'm like, what do you want?
Exactly. So even when what Tara just said, right? Because I kind of like what she said. The way she asked it, she kind of ticked off a few things and then said, what is a must have, or what's on your bucket list, right? She's like, you know, does it have, do you need it? You could just hit 2 or 3 things, right? How updated does it need to be? Do you mind any carpet? Or something like that, right? As long as you kind of check them off and then let me dream for a second, right? I would definitely just same way you just did it. Tara, it was awesome.
Thank you.
But kind of listen for those triggers, right? Yeah. I didn't have to talk about money at that point in time, but I kind of wanted to steer it towards money because my concern was, could I afford it? Right. So as soon as I bring a concern to you, you should automatically try to like knock it out, right? I forgot where I got this, but it's kind of like when you're having conversations and you have not a rebuttal, but you have some type of resistance, it's better to address it at that very point in time, as opposed to like getting to it at the end, right? Because maybe there you didn't give it to them all in context, right? They probably lost that thought and maybe just held on to that feeling, right? And then you're at the end of the conversation trying to bring them back to something that you talked about 20 minutes ago. Like, what? Like, yeah, but that one thing that you, you know? So if I say I have a concern, we're like, or you can just pause and be like, okay, I can understand that concern. What, you know, where are you at with this, right? So let's say my concern was neighborhood, right? So I want to be in a safe neighborhood. Now, as licensed realtors, I can't tell you what safe is.
We can ask what's a safe neighborhood to them.
No, I can ask you, you know, what's safe to you.
Yeah.
But then you might go down like a rabbit hole.
Yeah.
Right? So you kind of have to be careful, right? So I can understand that. I can understand that. Does it have to be a gated community?
Because that could make it safe for them if they think they're in a gated
community. Right? Mm-hmm. Because then I might say, I'm okay without being in a gated community as long as the area is safe. Because look, I'm in Delray. There's no, look where I'm at. There's no gates.
Yeah.
Right? Is this considered a safe community? To me, it is. Right? But there's no gates anywhere.
Yeah.
But if this person feels like a gate makes him safe, then it's a gate. Do you see?
Yeah.
So it might just have to be that you're just looking for a nice gated community as opposed to a nice community. Right? Mm-hmm. So those are questions that you want to ask them, or to get to the same point that you were saying when he was talking about white cabinets. And it's like, but this place is gorgeous. Just paint the cabinets white.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because what he really wanted was an open concept. He wanted an island. He didn't even give you a color scheme. You know, he just said, really, the whole place could have been brown as long as the fucking cabinets in the kitchen were white. Like, that's what you, and I would have sent him a property just like that, just to spite. I swear to God, I would have found one. The whole place could have been black and it just had white cabinets. I'm like, does that work? Is that what you were looking for? Like, well, not necessarily. Obviously, not necessarily.
Yeah.
Because the cabinets doesn't, there's cosmetic.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not the whole house, right?
Mm-hmm.
So just when you're having your conversations, because I'm, you know, I'm kind of running on time right now. I'm gonna let you guys go a little bit early because, you know, it's just a few of the gang here. But I hope you guys got something out of this. But when it comes to the calls that you'll be making this afternoon, right? I want you to think about what is not objective. I don't want to say objective, but what do you want to gain from the conversation, right? You get somebody on the phone, you want an appointment. Do you want somebody you know you can call back? That's kind of like when I make my phone calls. That's where I really where I'm on. I just want somebody I can call back.
Yeah.
And they're going to pick up and we're going to have a conversation about something.
I like almost want them to remember who I am.
Yeah. That's
if I say I'm Sydney, they're like, oh, real estate.
Right.
That's,
oh, yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, I remember.
There you go. You heard that, Tara?
Yep.
Okay. When I make a phone call, I want the person to remember who I am. Or by the end of the conversation, when they hear my voice again,
yeah,
they're going to know that and be excited.
And then they just pick up, hi, Sherry. Like, they just know.
I love it.
Yeah.
Because those are the best. Yeah. Those are the best clients, mm-hmm. right? Because even if they're not even ready to make a move today,
right.
they might know somebody
yeah.
who's, like, doing huge, right? It's, like, so crazy when your circle of friends, right? You'll have one friend who's a complete baller, right? And you have one as another that's a ball, right? But everybody's still on their own level,
mm-hmm.
right? I do have a story, but I'm not gonna bring it up. But but you'll be around people who, like, okay, maybe I can't do this right now, but I know somebody who is capable of doing it, and I think you'd be the great great person to help.
And then they'll be ready anyway.
And then they'll be even more ready.
Yeah.
Because think about it. What if you have you ever referred somebody to somebody else and you haven't used them, and then the person they used or the person you referred was, like, phenomenal?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And you didn't even use them yet, and your friend was like, man, that dude totally just saved my life, you know, or that girl just totally changed everything. She made sure everything was straight for me. Or whatever, right? Now that boosts you up as the person who referred, and you're going to keep on, even if you're still not in that position, you're still going to keep referring that person out.
Yeah.
Because you want your friends to be happy with knowing that that you know fucking somebody in real estate.
Mm-hmm.
Like, damn, man, you gave me Sherry? Shit. That girl's the best. That girl is the best. So I kind of want you to make, when you're making your calls today, I kind of want you to understand that we're getting from point A to point B. And your intention should be, this person should remember me, right? Not only for what I know, how I can help, but just in general, because they shouldn't want to use anybody else, right? Try to make it that kind of conversation. If the person is short on the phone with you, whatever, you don't have time, you know? But if you can get somebody who actually and it's that first 5 seconds, Tara, right?
Yeah.
It's that first 5 seconds, right? It's that Hey, is this Tara? Yes. Fantastic. Tara, this is Roney, the realtor from Delray Beach. I see you're on my website. You're looking at some properties. Just want to take a second to see how I can help you. And then pause. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And then right there, like, oh, yeah. Really? And if you have time, most likely you're going to talk to me. You're like, oh, yeah, I was just looking. And this is, a fantastic, I can understand just looking. Everybody starts somewhere. Ideally, what are you looking for? Right? Throw the question back at them. Ideally, what are you looking for? And then I should be able to, if I am looking, or I might have an idea, I'll give you the dream, right? This is what I want. I want it to be here on whatever, right? Well, great. I love that area. There's plenty of to do down there. I know this place to eat. I know this place to do that. I know this place. They have a fantastic winery. No. Make it all sweet, right? And then like, okay, time frame. And I love how you ask the time frame question. Is this something you're looking to do in the next 3 months, 3 to 6 months, or are we looking further out? Mm-hmm. Right? Because she knocked down. And I love it. She asked me twice.
Yeah.
Right? I didn't answer her, but she still asked twice a little bit. Mm-hmm. Right? And I like the way you kind of phrase that, right? And then find out the time frame. And then maybe ask for the money. Okay, ideally, what are you thinking about this? Is this going to be a permanent? If it's permanent, even better. Is this something that's going to be permanent, or is this like a second home?
Yeah.
Right? So I would go time frame. And then ask if this is a first or second home. First home, I'm going to spend everything. I'm going to get the top. Mm-hmm. It's a second home. If I got the bread, maybe I'll do that too. Right? Mm-hmm. But maybe I'm just testing the market. And I just want to see if I can get something mm-hmm. quickly before I do buy the big one. Right? So those questions and that kind of guiding yourself through that type of conversation will not only make you sound like a professional, it's also going to make you very trustworthy in regards to your craft. You know this market. The way you're talking makes it sound like I don't have time to waste, right? So if it's 3 to 6 months, okay, let's get started. Ideally, what are you looking for? Books and that, so on and so forth, right? So just kind of guide yourself through that, and then make it, when you're wrapping it up, obviously, it's going to be to the situation where, Tara, this is what I'm going to do, all right? You got to take small pauses, like someone who's thinking and who's going to drop something, some knowledge down, right? Like, Tara, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a preliminary search for you in regards to the criteria that you've shown me, okay? And then from there, we're going to touch back, I'll touch base with you, or I'll come, I'll touch base, or don't say follow up. I think touch base is supposed to be better. I'll touch base with you same time tomorrow. Does that sound okay?
Yes. Sounds great.
All right, cool. So what we'll do, you'll get that email. I'm going to send you a short text with my contact information. Just lock me in. And then this time around 11 o'clock tomorrow, we'll touch base and we'll go over the properties and see, what's the next step. Right. Boom. Right? And get them off. Mm-hmm. Right? Once we're there, you got to follow up. Do what you said you're going to do. Send out the email. I usually send that text out like
I do right away.
While I'm still on the phone, especially if I'm like on a dialer or something like that. So I got two of these things, so I'll text the information out. Boom, boom. It's out. I'm on to my next call. Mm-hmm. Right. And then I'll take notes. I have like little notepads. My desk is the worst thing ever. Right. I have like so many like little pieces of paper.
But you know where they go.
That's what yeah. It's like that. You ever watch The Usual Suspect?
No.
You never seen with Kevin Spacey?
No.
What? You never seen that?
I like Kevin Spacey, but I've
You've never seen Usual Suspect? The Usual Suspect?
No, I don't watch that.
Kaiser Sozak? You guys missing out on the world.
What is it on?
Have you ever seen it, Tara?
No.
Oh my God.
I do
oh
too.
My like, God.
Like House of Cards is my jam.
Oh my God. All right. The Usual Suspect.
What right? is it on?
It's an old movie. It's like from 19.
Oh, okay.
It's like 1990.
I did not remember.
1990 or 1993, something like that.
Make a note. The Usual Suspect.
Okay, Kevin Spacey. So in this movie, I'm not gonna give the whole thing away because you have to kind of watch it to understand, but it's a, the guy is telling a story and he's so detailed with it, but the whole story is a story. You have to watch the movie. Because what he does is he takes every bit of information that's given to him, he makes it part of the story and convinces these people to let him go.
Really?
Oh, that's incredible. And like, he's like the nacho boss, but you never know it. And he says something in there, and it's kind of like one of the lines of the movie. He goes, the greatest secret or the greatest trick that devil ever pulled is convincing the world he didn't exist. It's like one of the famous lines from the movie. I think it's a Scorsese, what's the other crazy guy? The one with the big head. Who did Pulp Fiction? What's his name?
Oh God.
He did Pulp Fiction. He does all like the
weird... Oh, are you talking Tarantino?
Tarantino. That's I think it might be either it's a Scorsese or it's a Tarantino movie. So you know that's two crazy bosses right there, right?
It's a Bryan Singer
movie. Bryan Singer? Mm-hmm. Okay. Even worse for me. All right. All right. So I mean, I guess we're gonna wrap this up, but I just want to thank you for being part of this conversation. I think it helps. I feel like more of a therapist than a complete role play guy, but I think throughout the role play itself, it's a mental, it's like a mental exercise, but it's also like, I don't know, there's like these small barriers that you know they're there, and then once you like crush one, you like your head's like, you know, like everything, this person is opening up to you, giving you like personal information, you know, talking about kids, talking about their family or whatever they are opening up, and it's like that human experience, you know, to me. I don't know.
Sometimes they just keep on talking.
Yeah, sometimes they'll talk your ear off. I mean, I'm a kind of,
it's okay.
I think it's fine.
Yeah.
If I can sit there and talk to somebody for 30 minutes that I've never talked to you before,
right. That's it.
That's
right.
Crazy. If you can get me on the phone for 30 minutes, and that's why I kind of gave this guy a chance because we met in person, you know, that's why I kind of gave him a chance. But then I just saw it. He just like gave up, you know, like so many little things. He just like shot him down. And it's kind of like, damn, man, you're not really trying. You know, it's not you're really trying, but you're not really trying.
It's like an old school sales
approach. Yeah. Like,
show up suit and tie. Or
he wasn't in a suit and tie, but he was definitely like the shoes he wore were like, whoa, like too, like they didn't match. Like they were too flashy for like what he was wearing, you know, like he had like, yeah, it was crazy. It was like the ones with like the studs and stuff, like it was all black, like something you would wear with like that I would wear with some really nice pants, like if I'm going out.
Yeah,
like yeah,
those are Valentinos.
They weren't really Valentino.
No, but they're supposed to be
Valentino. They were. I know they were because there was no way you walk around Valentinos like that. Like he was walking the streets like
there's
a random
a lot of
person,
of us.
Yeah. You know. So yeah, so he was wearing those, but like with like some worn out khakis and a really weird. I don't know. It was just strange to me, and I was just like, all right, bro. I know you're trying. Mm-hmm. I got you. You know, but just let's try to figure out, you know, how we can make business or how we can work together. He wasn't interested. He was just interested in trying to sell me. And it was just like, all right, you already lost because I'm not buying your product. You know, I'm not buying your product, but maybe I know somebody who can. But the fact that I can't trust you, not even trust you.
You didn't feel comfortable.
I didn't feel comfortable to give, to bring you to somebody that
I know. Like if it's a salesperson, I feel like you should feel comfortable to bring them to meet your friends, to refer them. Like you should feel comfortable doing that.
And if you're,
that rapport that you have.
Yeah. And if not, my friends are going to look at me like, or people that I think, who I have value for, you know, to present to somebody.
You know, like, why are you wasting my time?
Why are you fucking wasting my time?
Yeah.
All right.
Thank
I'm sorry,
you,
guys.
Thank you.
All right. Well, thank you very much for participating. You know, you guys were all cool. You're a not signed in. I don't know what that means. Is this on here? All right. I guess we're all out. All right. Have a good one. Take care, folks. I think I started a little early.
All right. See you guys later.
All right, see you later.
Yeah, I think I started it like 15 minutes.
Wasn't there something now? Something
there's a the lender Q&A.
Oh.
Stop share. I'm gonna close this. Leave meeting.
Prescriptions.
Assign a name. Can I just leave? Assign a new host. No. Cancel. We just close.
I think we just.
I just close it.
And meeting for all.
And meaningful.